प्रथम भगवती जी को विनती है हम सबको आशीर्वाद प्रदान करें।
Param Puja Swamiji, Param Puja Bhai Shri, Shri Hasubhai, Srimati Harshaben, all of the wonderful committee trustees, and all of the community of this divine Hari Mandir. It's such a great joy, such a great honor to be here on this wonderful occasion of your 25th anniversary. A temple in our lives plays so many important roles. We may think it's not that important. We may think it's merely a symbol, merely some place to go. We go because we're supposed to. We go because someone tells us to go. And yet, the role that the temple plays in our lives actually holds within it the keys to everything that we really need in our life. This afternoon, as Puja Swamiji and I were driving here from Pittsburgh, we passed by a church. And outside of the church, there was a sign. They always have these beautiful signs outside with some kind of slogan or inspiring saying. And the saying said, "Watch your thoughts and you can see the future. Watch your thoughts and you'll see the future." Today, modern religion, science, is saying what the Vedic rishis said thousands of years ago, that our thoughts create our future. But not only our future, they create our present. Every minute and every moment, every day, is being created by what we think. And not only that which is happening to us, but that which is happening to all of those around us. Modern scientific research is showing the power of our thoughts on everything ranging from the rate at which a tree or a plant will sprout, blossom, and grow, to the rate at which our machines function well and quickly or freeze and stop altogether, to how well our immune systems work. Not only the immune systems within our bodies, but they can take cells from an immune system, put them in a petri dish in a science laboratory, and without even putting our hand on it, the power of our thoughts is changing and impacting the rate that those cells are growing. So modern science is finally beginning to catch up slowly, slowly, with what the Vedic rishis said so long ago. Watch our thoughts. And yet, how many of us really do it? How much attention do we really pay to where our minds go, where our thoughts go? Someone who sleepwalks, who wakes up in the middle of the night and finds that his legs have taken him miles from home, goes to the doctor, gets medicine, gets treatment. We realize sleepwalking is a disease. Our legs should not take us where we don't want to go. There's a disease called Tourette syndrome, where sometimes in the middle of a sentence, people will find themselves shouting obscenities, shouting insults, completely inappropriate remarks. a disease. They get treatment. They get medication. We realize that our legs, our tongues, our bodies should be under our control. But our minds, our thoughts, this incredibly powerful tool, probably the most powerful tool that we've been given to shape today, tomorrow, and our entire future. We just let it go. And we say things like, oh, that's just my silly mind. Or, oh, that's just my wandering mind. Can you imagine if I sat here, and as I was speaking to you, suddenly my arms started going like this. Or suddenly I started bouncing up and down. You'd say, she's crazy. And if I said to you, oh, that's just my silly arms, or those are just my legs, you'd say, she's really crazy. So why is it that we realize so deeply and so innately that we should have control of our arms, our legs, our mouth, our tongues? But the most important tool we've been given to create our own lives, we don't even bother to pay attention to it. That's the role that the temple plays. When we come into the temple, immediately it focuses our thoughts. Immediately it says, sit down, do japa. Chant mantras, say your prayers, do not let your mind wander. Immediately it says to us, chant the names of the Lord. And it says to us, take that home with you. Every lecture, every pravachan, everything you're going to hear from the gurus, even the priests says, chant your japa, jap karte raho. Chahe aap gaadi chala rahe, chahe bhojan bana rahe, jo bhi hai, jap karte raho. It's not just that jap is so powerful, it's that it controls the mind, keeps it from roaming off in all kinds of directions. So when we come to temple, it helps give in our hands the keys, the reins, to taking care of the most important thing we have. That which can lead us to incredible heights or lead us to absolute ruin, our own minds. And when we come, we have darshan of the divine. We have Hanumanji's darshan, and he reminds us that with God's grace, everything is possible, and only with God's grace. Otherwise, we walk in here, and usually we feel like, I'm the one in charge. I'm the smart one. I'm the one doing my job. I'm the one who did the successful project. I'm the one who made this happen. I'm the one who made that happen. And if we didn't come to temple, we might keep believing that. We might spend our entire lives in that illusion. But we come to temple, we bow our head, and we hear in our mind Hanumanji's voice when at the end of the war he was asked, how did you do it? How did you fly across the oceans? How did you carry the Himalayas in your hand? How did you make yourself so big and so tiny? He didn't say, oh, well, you know, I've been going to the gym and working out 5 days a week. He didn't say, I have these wonderful soy protein shakes that I take every morning. He didn't say it's some special tonic. He didn't even say it's a special mantra. He said, I just close my eyes and I take Bhagwan Ram's name, or baki unki upare, baki unki kripa se hoti hai. And it reminds us that whether we've managed to fly across oceans and carry mountains, or whether we've simply managed to complete a project or succeed a little bit, that it's all due to His grace. And that without His grace, nothing is possible. But with His grace, nothing is impossible.